Hello friends, welcome to Efficient Learning World. So today in this video we are going to learn about the program that will help us to shut down our PC. Okay, so in previous video I explained you the program to play music and different songs in C++. We generate different sounds in C++, so if you not have watched that video, so kindly watch that video. Okay, so in today video we are going to learn about the program that will help us to shut down our PC. Okay, so this code is for basically for C++, but you can also use this code in the C language, because you know the C++ is the standard version of C by Dennis Ritchie. Okay, so there is a minor difference between the syntax of C++ and C. In C++ we mostly use the iostream header file, which is the basically the standard header file in C++, but if you are using the C language, we use mostly stdio.h and stdlib.h header file. Okay, but you can also use these two header files in the C++ language as well, because C++ is the advanced version of C. Okay, so you can either use any type of syntax. Okay, so I will explain you whatever the code I will explain you, you just have to write that code in this main function. Okay, so you can write my code in the main function in the C++, this syntax and this syntax as well. So okay, so I will just use a function that will I explain you in the editor. So that function you just have to write here, okay, in the main function, and your program will run compile successfully. So now coming towards our major task. So how you turn off your computer? So mostly people turn off their computer using pressing the power button. Mostly user use the shortcut key, that is Alt+F4. Mostly user, in fact 90% users use this method, that is going on the start button and then click on the power button and then shut down your PC. So this is the most easiest method, but in today video we are not going to use any type of these method. Instead of these, we are going to write a program. Program means some sort of coding that will help us to perform our task. What is our task? To shut down our computer. So we are going to write some sort of coding that will help us to shut down our computer. So let's see. Okay, so I just open my editor. I'm using the dev editor. You can use any type of editor like code blocks, Visual Studio, Atoms, Sublime Text, etc. So you can use any type of editor. Okay, so the code will be same for all type of editors, but the with the operating system it will there will be a minor difference, so I will explain you later. So you can see this is the these are the two standard header files. Okay, we are used in C language, but if you are using the C++ language, you can also use this two languages. Okay, for example, I run compile and run my code, so you can see my code successfully run and compile. Okay, so the you can use you mostly use these two header files in the C language, but you can also use these header files in the C++ language as well. But if you have not learned the C language, then you can simply write here the hash include iostream header file, which is a basically the standard header file mostly used in the C++ language. Okay, so you can use simply just iostream header file and compile and run, and this code will be compiled and run successfully. So you can use any method, for example iostream header file and the stdio.h and stdlib.h header file. Okay, but our main task is writing some code in the main function that will help us to shut down our PC. So I am going to use here a system function. So what it means by the system function? Or if you watched my previous video, I already explained the system function, and because this system function is really used mostly in use in C++ language, okay, in the C language as well, to shut down or restart our PC computer system in the C++ program, we will use this system function. It is defined in stdlib.h header file. Okay, so and in the C++ it is defined in the windows.h header file or the conio.h header file. So the system function invokes the command processor to execute a command. The command processor for Windows based is mostly is the cmd. okay, so for Windows command processor is cmd. okay, but for window for the Linux user it's terminal. Okay, it's terminal. These information maybe you will learn in the introduction to computing subject. Okay, so mostly in the bachelors will know this, that for the Windows we use command processor as a cmd, or for Linux it is called terminal. Okay, so to shut down or restart over PC, we just have to place the command corresponding to shut down or restart inside this system function. Okay, so I just write some spaces. Okay, so we just have to write some sort of code. Okay, so some sort of instruction in this system function that will help us to shut down our PC. So in the this system function, you just have to write in double quotes, that will be the C colon backslash two times, and then write Windows and backslash backslash and system 32 backslash backslash and shut down. Okay, so a single space and then front slash and then write a S. Okay, so this S means shut down my PC. Okay, so this is the code. Okay, so if I it means that in the C language, in the C directory, go to in Windows folder and then system 32 folder and then execute the shutdown exe file. Okay, so if I'm going, so this is a by default, this is always in all type of operating system window for Windows especially. Okay, so this code is for Windows user. I will explain also for Linux user and for the Windows XP user as well. So this code is for Windows user. If I open my file explorer and then I just have to go in the Windows folder. Okay, first of all, I just have to go in the C directory, then Windows folder, you can see Windows folder, and then the system 32 folder. So I'm just right in the search box, that is system 32. Okay, so this is the system 32 folder, and then I just have to write here shutdown. Okay, so shutdown, so you can see there is are different shutdown folders. Okay, so this is the shutdown exe file. Whenever you turn off your PC, this shutdown exe file executes. Okay, and your PC certainly immediately shut down. Okay, so this is the exe file which I will execute this exe file using my C++ coding. Okay, so this is all for this system function. You just have to compile and run your code, and when you compile and run your code, immediately after 30 to 60 seconds, this your PC will shut down. Okay, so the system gets shut down in default time, that is about 30 to 60 seconds after executing this program. So after executing this code, your computer system gets shut down after 30 to 60 seconds. That is the by default time. Okay, so you can also define timer in say number of seconds. Okay, we have use system function that invokes the command processor to execute a command, that is S, or S means shut down my PC. Okay, so if you compile and run your code, so after 30 to 60 seconds your PC will shut down. But if you want immediately shut down your computer, means when you compile and run your code, your computer will immediately turn off. So you just have to specify here time. Okay, so front slash T means it is specifying the time, and you just have to write here the number of seconds after you want your PC will turn off. So I'm writing here just zero. Okay, so if you want to shut down your Windows based system immediately, then provide the timer as 0 seconds. Okay, so zero means this will, whenever you compile and run your code, the system will immediately turn off. Okay, so T means timer, S means shutdown, and zero is specifying the number of seconds. And if you want that after 2 minutes or 30 minutes or 50 minutes your PC will shut down, means you are trying to specify the timing, then you can also write here the number of seconds, not number of minutes, not number of hours, but number of seconds. For example, if I want that after 2 minutes my PC will shut down, then I just have to write here number of seconds. And in 2 minutes there are 120 seconds, because in 1 minute there are 60 seconds. So it means that in 2 minutes there are 120 seconds. So after 20 seconds my PC will shut down as I compile and run my code. Okay, so this is for Windows user. Now for Linux user. Okay, so for Windows XP user, if you are a Windows XP user, then you just have to write this code, but there is a little bit difference, that is minus S, and the another things will be remain same, that by front slash T means timer, and you can also write here zero means immediately turn off your PC. Okay, so this is for Windows user syntax. And let's suppose if you are a Linux user, so for Linux user you just try have to also use this function, system function. Okay, so in the double quotes you just write here shutdown and minus P and write here now. Okay, So what it means, if you are a Linux user, you just have to write this function, but and this line in the double quotes. But if you are a Windows user, you just have to write this. Okay, so for Linux user, if you are writing this, so my so you need to be logged in as root user for this program, for Linux, not for Windows and Windows XP. I am explaining you for Linux user because you need to be logged in as a root user for this program to execute, otherwise you will get the message shutdown, need to be root. Okay, so this now means that this now specifies that you want to shut down immediately, and this minus p specifies you want to power off your machine. Okay, p means power off, and you can also write here number of times. If you want that after 2 minutes you want to shut down your PC, you can write here 3. So 3 means after 3 minutes, and if you are writing here 2, so it means that after 2 minutes your PC will shut down. But yeah, if you see the difference in the Windows and the Linux user, this is number of times. Okay, so this is number of times specifying here 2 means say 2 minutes, but here 2 means after 2 seconds my PC will turn off. Okay, so this is for Windows, this is for Linux user, and this is for Windows XP user. For Windows user, there is another shortcut method shortcut method. Okay, so I'm going to explain you a shortcut method instead of writing this Windows system 32 shutdown / s. Okay, so this, instead of this you can also use system function, but instead of writing this you just have to write here shutdown and a single space, and then write here minus s, so and a semicolon, which is the terminator of this line. Okay, so for this is for Windows a shortcut key. Okay, this is basically a shortcut function shutdown. Okay, shutdown. Okay, so this is you can use any method. For example, this is a shortcut method. Mostly this is not used because in some editor it will give you error. Okay, so mostly people use this function. Okay, so this function that I explained you, that system Windows system 32 shutdown s / s means shutdown, and / t means time, number of times, how many number of times you want that your PC will shut down, and then you just have to write here the time, the specifying the time, number of seconds. Okay, so if you, I am writing here 60, so it means that after 60 seconds my PC will shut down. But if I want that after immediately compiling and run my code my PC will shut down, then I just have to write here 0 means after 0 seconds my PC will shut down. Okay, so you can write here any type of code as you wish. For Linux user, you just have to write here shutdown minus p means power off, and there then you have to write here the number of minutes after you want that your PC will shut down. And for the Windows XP users, you just have to write here also Windows system 32 shutdown, as I explained you for Windows, but a little bit difference that in Windows you just have to write here / s, but in the Windows XP user you just have to write here minus s. Okay, so this is for now. I am not compile and run my program, you see, because if I compile and run my program, then how can I record my video, because my PC will suddenly immediately shut down. Okay, my PC will turn off, and how can I record my video? So I am not compiling and run my code, but you can also implement this code, and you can use this code to turn off your PC. Okay, so if you want to turn off your PC, you just have to comment this. Okay, so I'm just commenting it. So you just have to write this line of code. Okay, so a single line. So when you write this line, and you just have to compile and run your code. So as you compile and run your code, after 0 seconds your PC will suddenly immediately turn off. Okay, so this is for now. In the today video we see that how to turn off your shut down your computer using C++ coding. Okay, so you can use this code in the C language as also, but in the C language you have you don't have to write this line, that is using namespace std. okay, so this line is not used in C language, but is in the C++ language. Okay, so for variables this is another topic that will I explain you in the later videos, upcoming videos, but in the today videos you just write include the header files, that is the stdio.h and stdlib.h header file. Okay, so if you write this code, then this will be for both the C language and C++ language. Okay, so if you want to write only for C++ language, then you can also use this code. And another method is /include iostream header file. So this is for those users who have not learned the C language, okay? But if you have learned the C language and the C++ language as well, then you can use any method, for example this method or this method, okay? So this will be valid for both. So in this today video, we see that how to turn off your PC. You just have to write the system function, and then you just have to include the path of the shutdown.exe file in your PC. But this is for Windows user. If you are Linux user, you just have to write a shutdown -pp means power off, and then number of times you have to specify in the function as an argument. And for Windows XP user, you just have to write also include the path of the Windows shutdown exe file. Okay, so thanks for watching this video. If you find any ambiguity or confusion in this code or another code, you can comment on this video. I will definitely explain you and try my best to resolve your issues. So thanks for watching this video, and please subscribe my channel, Efficient Learning World.